1370 WOCA. Ocala.
All right, 5 minutes after 9 o'clock, it's time for Veterans News. Hank Whittier is in the studio. Good morning, Hank.
It is a good morning, Larry. Thank you. Not a good morning as far as casualties are concerned, though. We've got a lot of casualties. And I know you got somebody on the line already,
sir.
So we need to, might as well get right
Captain
to it.
Captain Wellborn is on the phone. Script. Good morning, Captain. You're on the air now.
Good morning. Unfortunately, we've had another week of multiple fatalities in the fire service. We'll start with a volunteer firefighter, Dale Scott Queen. He's a 37-year-old. He worked for Oak Ridge Volunteer Fire Department in Hartsville, Alabama. He succumbed to an illness while working in call of an explosion. That was on April the 29th. We have a volunteer firefighter, Gene Kirchner, age 24, 9 years of service at Baltimore County Fire Department, Towson, Maryland. Sustained some injuries at the scene of working a residential structure fire. This happened on May the 2nd. We had a volunteer assistant fire chief, Stanley Martin Jr., 71 years old, 20 years of service at Springfield Volunteer Fire Department, Utah, Alabama. Went into cardiac arrest while battling a structure fire. Age was 71, and this happened on May the 6th. And we had a firefighter, Daniel Davidson, 26 years old, Sacramento Ranger District of the Lincoln National Forest in Cloudcroft, New Mexico. Died of a medical emergency on May the 5th of this year. To date, we've had 29 firefighter fatalities that have been reported to the USFA in 2013. That's the end of the report.
Hey, listen, thank you. Stay safe, my friend. Be good
all
out
right.
There. Yeah. Well, Don's trying to break the studio apart here.
That's right.
What found?
I don't
breaking
know.
The barrier.
He's remodeling for you. Yeah. Is anybody else on the line?
No, sir.
I'm not sure. I forgot whether the Sheriff's Department had casualties or not, but it's been a bad week, particularly for the military. Vivian tried to send me stuff. It wouldn't come through for some reason. I don't know. So I had to handwrite it. So you won't read my writing, guys. Let me do it. All of these are killed in Afghanistan. United States Army Staff Sergeant Mike Simpson, 30. He was from Texas. Specialist Trinidad Santiago, 25, from California. PFC Charles McClure, 21, from Oklahoma. First Lieutenant Brandon Lathram, 26, from Oklahoma. Staff Sergeant Francis Phillips, 28, State of New York. Specialist Kevin Cardoza, 19, from Texas. Specialist Thomas Morash, age 22, from Idaho. Specialist Brandon Prescott, 24, from Oregon. Air Force casualties, Captain Mark Voss, 27, from Colorado. Technical Sergeant Herman McKay, 30, from California. Captain Victoria Pinckney, 27, from California. United States Marine Corps casualties, Staff Sergeant Eric Christian, 39, from New York. And lastly, from the United States Marine Corps, Corporal David Sonica, 23, from Colorado. A very bad week in Afghanistan. I don't know if we've got... and no one's on the line? Okay. Don't have it in front of me because we had a little trouble with the computer last night, so I'm not sure that we have one or not. Anybody have anybody local they want to mention? I know you got a sick call thing you want to do. You want to do your sick call?
I'll do the sick call. We have Stephen Harris, the husband of Mary Harris from Golden, Ocala, Marine, recovering from a stomach ailment in operation. And we have Pablo Martinez from the Sheriff's Department who is recovering. He has a couple broken bones in his leg and broken hand. Motorcycle accident, so he's doing very well. He's a former Marine. Once a Marine, always a Marine. So good luck to those guys, and I'm glad to see they're on their way to healing.
Okay, good. All right. Well, listen, Will, I assume there's nobody from the Sheriff's Department calling in, so go ahead and do your amazing grace, and we'll move on. Thank you, guys.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now
okay, Larry. Yeah, I say a bad week across the board. For you got somebody on the line now? Yes, probably the sheriff's. Right?
Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning, Hank. This
oh, is Sonny. How you doing, bud?
To me, the only way you're going to stop these idiots or crazies from killing Americans because Americans are number one. If we weren't there, they'd be still killing. They'd be killing each other. So, I would make the cost of killing an American so horrendous that these people would just leave us alone and can't wait for us to get the heck out of there. That's just for openers.
Mm-hmm.
You had a young woman over there who was killed because she was going around to, I guess, the different provinces or whatever, distributing books to girls for a girls' school.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. It happened a few weeks ago, yeah.
Yeah. And their excuse is, well, gee, we were telling everybody where the books were going to be so the people could gather to get them. Yeah. We didn't learn our lessons from the last time we took some Afghani security forces in our helicopter on a raid on some terrorist location. And what happened? Our Chinook was shot down, and how many, was it 20-some-odd lives Americans were lost in that deal?
Hey, Sonny.
And yet we continue to do the same thing over and over again.
Yeah, I agree.
And it's a time that I think we should get some real officers in leadership in our military, number one. And number two, we should have been out of there, out of Afghanistan a long time ago. If these people wanted to keep destroying their own country, you know, they've been doing it for 1,000 years, so why stop them now? Well, that's my thought.
It's what's going to happen with all the sacrifice as soon as you leave. Okay, as soon as you leave. Worse shape than Iraq was in, Afghanistan is in.
Well, it's not because we didn't throw enough money.
Well, it's not. You know what? I don't care. You know, Sonny, really, I care about money. But, you know, if we spent 100 times what we spent, but I sure don't like losing over 2,000 American lives.
You got it. It's not
worth one American life. Not
that's
one.
That's what I've been saying all
not
along.
One. By the way, did you see the hearings yesterday?
Excuse me?
You see the hearings yesterday on Benghazi?
Yeah. No, I didn't.
I couldn't see them.
Interesting stuff. I didn't know old Hillary Clinton called the chief of security there, Hicks, at 2 o'clock in the morning, and knew then that that wasn't a result of some spontaneous event. She was told what was going on.
Yeah, she knows all that. We know she knows all that,
sure.
Even though she lied about it.
Yeah.
But the fact of the matter is, why was our ambassador on the anniversary of 9/11 in a place, an undefendable place like Benghazi, when he should have been in the embassy? He is the ambassador.
Well, in addition to that, why weren't we on high alert? Why weren't military strike units available, and not just for Benghazi, but across the world? But apparently, someone was asleep. You know, Dennis Miller had, I think, the best response to this whole Benghazi thing and the lack of transparency. He said, you know, had it been the other way around and Americans killed four Libyans, they would have turned the investigation upside down to find out how those and who, what Americans were responsible, and
exactly.
That, you know, and again, but four Americans get killed, and what does she say? What does it matter, right?
What does it matter?
Yeah. Our friend Hillary, like, who's getting ready to run for next time around.
Death always seems to be around that woman. Even when she was first lady of the governor in the governor's house, there were state troopers dying for some crazy reason. And there was.
Well, I think we got a good view of her again when she made that statement. What does it matter? I think spoke volumes about the woman. But listen, run. I got Sonny. I got a lot of people coming in, and then I got to run, buddy. Good. Hey, Sonny, we'll catch you next week. I got a real short schedule today. I got to get to two or three different places here in about 10 minutes. There's supposed to be somebody coming in to talk about the honor flight going out of Lady Lake. Maybe you got lost. Probably follow my directions, guys.
Follow
my directions. I give good directions.
He went to Roberts.
That's right. I send everybody to Roberts.
They end up in Miami.
Before you do the Roberts and the college and Lincoln and Ford Lincoln and all that stuff, come on in, Mr. Driscoll. Outstanding. And listen, there is something else going on, and the DAV is doing a flag retirement ceremony in support of disabled American veterans and all veterans of the armed forces. They're going to do a flag retirement ceremony to dispose of the flag properly. So bring your torn, tattered flags down to the DAV post down there on Baseline Road. That's between Bellevue and Ocala, 58th Avenue. State Road 35? 35. Baseline Road, same thing. It's easy to find. Big flag outside right next to Stone Petroleum. And it's going to be the 19th of this month. 1 to 5 p.m. with the ceremony starting at 2 p.m. Rain or shine, they're going to have it. And they want you to come on down, have something to eat and something to drink. They're going to provide food and entertainment as well. Johnny Calvin is going to be doing some DJ work. And say they get free food, free beverages. They're going to do a ceremony on retirement of the torn and tattered American flags. And join them. That's the 19th, and they're looking forward to having you there. They're looking for a big crowd, and I'm glad they're doing it to dispose of those flags properly. So the other one is 4209 with their fish fries and all the good stuff that they do over there on 36th Avenue. Go on over there Friday night and give it a shot. Listen, guys, Mr. Driscoll's here from On a Flight, right?
That's correct.
All right, listen, I've got a short schedule today. This is John Rose and Curly and... These guys are gonna right after the break. They're gonna put you on to talk about all the good things that you're doing down
right.
there. John's got to do a little bit of. We got to pay the bills.
We got to pay the bills, right? Well, today's Veterans News is brought to you by Robert's Funeral Homes and Cemeteries. They provide 24-hour assistance. They have great, caring, knowledgeable staff, full-service funeral arrangements, reputable facility, and they're provide itemized lists of costs, and they will accommodate you and your needs and with your requests. And they've been doing all this great stuff for over 120 years.
You know, they've been following me around.
They have.
Yeah, but the hearse has been right behind my truck for the last week. I think they know something
I don't. You have that. You had that special with them. That's a one-time only special. It's like the blue light special.
Yeah, the accounting's easy in my case. Yeah.
It's under a dollar or under.
I think it's a 99-cent special.
You don't get much with that.
Yeah. Well, I don't give much either, so I don't deserve it, you know.
And you don't care then either. And that leads us right
into
some great transportation. Ward Lincoln of Ocala, their goal is to ensure that they're one of the best Ward Lincoln dealers in all of Florida, probably all the country. They offer a great selection of new and used cars and trucks, have great financing, lease, those kind of specials. They also have a tremendous parts repair and service department for your Lincoln and Ford products. And we also remind you that they have Village Ford in Bellevue, and that's also, we're looking forward to the opening of that brand new location down in Bellevue.
Very good.
And we have our newest sponsor is St. Leo University of Ocala. It's approved for a veterans educational and training under the GI Bill. It's a participating member of the Yellow Ribbon Program. And why would you pick St. Leo University? Because it's flexible and convenient. They're going to give you personal attention from the start until you graduate. And it's affordable academic excellence. So,
it's a good deal. Get in there and do that GI Bill thing, which
is
much improved. Right? Yeah, and St. Leo's, you know, they've got skilled people who are going to kind of lead you through the way and all the maze and veterans counselors and that sort of stuff. Get a degree because the world has changed, and honestly, you need a degree in something.
And hopefully you'll get it in something that's marketable.
Hopefully so. Listen, we got to go ahead and take a break. We come back, we're going to talk a little bit about Honor Flight. Folks out of Lady Lake are doing that, and they got a lot of information. They're going to continue doing that where some of the other groups have kind of dropped it. I've got to go to a bunch of meetings, so I'm going to get on out of here, and I know that makes everybody a little happier than you'll probably listen to the show now. Tell your neighbors, Hank's gone, you can listen.
You can listen, right?
All right, guys, have a good day. We'll talk to you later.
Life's journey has many ups and downs, but you can take comfort in the knowledge that Robert's Funeral Home is here to serve you and your family with loving care and dignity. The Roberts family has been providing their caring services since 1898 and offer traditional, custom, cremation, and veteran services. Pre-made arrangements are also available. Roberts Funeral Homes, great funeral homes serve great people.
We may not have the kind of winters they have up north, but Florida weather can be still pretty rough on your ride. And Ford Lincoln of Ocala wants to save you money and time during their Restore Your Ride service event. Right now, you can drive into Ford Lincoln of Ocala, receive a free brake inspection, and if it's determined you need brake work, you can receive up to a $50 rebate on any Motorcraft brake service when you use your Ford service credit card. And if it's tires you need, Ford Lincoln of Ocala's completely satisfied service center can hook you up with up to $120 in rebates on any of the top brands backed by their low price tire guarantee. So stop chasing all over town for this service and that service. Get it all done right, the right way, at the right place at Ford Lincoln of Ocala during their Restore Your Ride event. There's also great savings on Motorcraft batteries, wiper blades. You know, my dad used to say, don't wait till it's too late, get it done now. Visit Ford Lincoln of Ocala's completely satisfied service center, open Monday through Friday, 7:30 to 6, and Saturdays till 5.
Programming support for Veteran News is brought to you in part by St. Leo University's Ocala Center. Claim your future with a highly respected degree from St. Leo University. This year, St. Leo University proudly celebrates 40 years of educating military students and their families. St. Leo University's Ocala Center offers flexible bachelor's and master's degree programs designed for working adults. Classes are forming now. You can learn more about St. Leo University's convenient degree programs offered in Ocala, Lecanto, and Lake Sumter by visiting stleo.edu/Ocala.
It's been 500 years since Spanish explorers first set foot on Florida's shores, naming our beautiful state Florida because of the many varieties of colorful flowers the Spaniards could see. I want to tell you another piece of history that is actually not his story, but her story. It's about all of the moms in your life. You and I wouldn't have a history if it wasn't for her story. And with Mother's Day this Sunday, you'll be happy to know that Kenny's Place Nursery has knockout roses on sale. Get mom a 1 gallon size for just $8 and a 3 gallon size for just $15. Celebrate Mother's Day and her story with the same thing that gave Florida her name, flowers. Kenny's Place Nursery is located at 7677 Southeast 41st Court in Ocala. Give them a call at 867-1213. Kenny's Place Nursery, where the plants, the people, and the mission are all beautiful.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
Right, 26 minutes after 9 o'clock, let's return to Veterans News. Hank Whittier has stepped out on his way to a meeting, and John Rose is sitting in the captaincy. Good morning, John.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Yeah, we're trying to fill in for Hank, you know. He's a tough act to follow, you know.
Yeah.
He wanted to remind us that we better start off and make sure that everybody knows who made this possible. We have our continuing sponsors, and we also have one brand new one. And we'll start off with St. Leo University of Ocala. They do approve veterans educational training through the GI Bill. They're a participant of a member of the Yellow Ribbon Program. They're flexible and convenient for those people here in Ocala, and they're going to give you personal attention from the start to graduation. Affordable, and they provide affordable academics excellence. So what more could you ask for from higher education, and use that GI Bill if you're a veteran out there. We also have Ford Lincoln of Ocala. Again, their goal is to ensure that they're one of the best Ford Lincoln dealers in Florida, and they do that by offering a great selection of new and used vehicles, cars and trucks. They have great financing. They have leases and other specials. They have a great service to back up your purchase of your vehicle, especially Lincolns and Fords, and they have parts and repairs as well. And they also have the store in Bellevue. It's called Village Ford, and it won't be too long, and they'll be moving into their new location. So we're all looking forward to that. Our other sponsor been with us for a long time. We can't say the 120 years that they've been in business, but they've been with us right from the start, and that's Robert Funeral Homes and Cemeteries. Their caring, knowledgeable staff provide 24-hour assistance, and they're a full-service, reputable facility. You'll get an itemized list of the prices, and a funeral home will accommodate your needs and requests that you have, and they've been doing this for over 120 years in our community, and that in itself should tell you that they've been doing the right thing, because you don't stay in business for over 120 years if you're not providing the correct service. So we thank all those sponsors. And I guess quickly we'll maybe do some of our announcements, and then we'll go to John Driscoll, who's going to talk about Honor Flight. So, Curly, you want to start off?
Yeah, good morning, everybody. The VFW Post 7193 will meet today at 6 p.m. at the Mount Moriah Missionary Baptist Church Annex. The location is 55 Southwest 3rd Avenue, right downtown Ocala. The women's part of the VFW Post, which is called the Women's Auxiliary of 7193, will also meet there, but their time starts at 4:30 p.m. Would also remind you that the District 22 convention will be up in Astor Post at 9886, or is it 9680-68? Not quite sure, but anyway, it's Astor Post on Highway 40 East. Just keep traveling on 40 East until you see it.
See all those cars.
Yeah,
right?
See all those cars. And we'll be glad to see each and every one of you there. It's the district convention. It starts, get there about 11, and you make sure you're there for the entire afternoon's entertainment, because they're going to have lunch at the post. And from there, we start our meeting at 1 o'clock, a joint meeting, and then we'll break. From there, we usually have... The ladies will separate and have their separate meeting, and the men will have their meeting.
But anyway, they do elections too, right?
Yeah, this time they also do our elections. So be there and make sure that somebody's there to also represent your post, so that we can have a full day and get through and get out of there. So make sure that, like I said, it's a district convention, so everybody please be there, and so we can have a good election and have a good time in District 22. That's all I got today, John. Just a matter that we have a meeting this evening and that the district is meeting on Saturday.
Okay, thank you. We got a couple other things going on. If you happen to be in the Bellevue Candler area, I know of Mother's Day at Candler Post 4493 VFW. From 9 to 11, they have breakfast, and that's all you can eat thing, and it's $6. I'm not too sure if the all those mothers are free or not, but it's a great breakfast. And if maybe Jack would remember, if he's out there spraying bugs, he'll tell us that whether the mothers are free. And he'll be over there working. And then from noon to 3 over at the American Legion Post in Bellevue, it's just 55th Avenue. It's behind Checkers, about 3 blocks. We're going to have a half a chicken dinner, and it's a donation of $5, and we have both barbecue and baked chicken. That's a half a chicken. And, again, come on over and enjoy camaraderie and have a good meal. On May the 16th, which is next Thursday, is the Marion County Veterans Council, 10:30 at the main library, and we'd like everybody to attend. And it gives us a chance for all those organizations to send a representative, become a member if you so desire. And what we do is try to coordinate what's going on and put out or listen to information that's going on and things that are pertinent to veterans. So stop by and join us and help coordinate those events. On May the 27th is going to be the Memorial Day programs, and there's one at the park, starts at 10:30, and around noontime is the one over at Hires Baxley. It has I forget what the Memorial Garden's name is, but I think we all know Hires Baxley, and they have their regular program, and they'll be doing their student essays at the same time. So, and that's after the event at the park, so you can attend both of them and have a great day. And they have refreshments, and I think they usually have entertainment. So that's another good thing. And I think that's the announcements I have. So without any further ado, we have honored to have John Driscoll, who is a coordinator for the Village's Honor Flight, here to tell us about their program.
Well, I'm glad to be here. I just hope that it's not an indication of what's going on. I show up and the host of the show leaves. So,
is that all it takes to get rid of them?
Well, Well, we've Village Honor Flight is part of the National Honor Flight organization. Our hub was started back in 2011. We flew our first flights last year in 2012. We had four flights scheduled, and we flew three of them, and the fourth flight didn't fly because of Hurricane Sandy that came up the East Coast. We were supposed to fly that day, and if we had flown, we probably would still be stuck in Washington. So we didn't fly that day. This year, we took everyone who was on that flight and rescheduled them for this year, and we have seven flights scheduled for this year. We've already completed two. We have one that's leaving the 25th of this month. One will be leaving in June. We take the summer off because it's too hot in Washington during July and August. Then we have one flying in September, October, and November. The one in September, and the model we use is we fly 25 vets and 25 guardians, and then five staff. And the reason we come up with that number is when we get to Washington, the tour buses and the charter buses that you get can accommodate 56 people. So we can't fly over 56, or else we have to get another bus. So at the present time, we're just flying 25 vets, and each vet gets a guardian, and each vet also gets a wheelchair. It's a long day for the vets, and when we get to the World War II Memorial and start walking down the memorial and walking down to the Korean War Memorial and over to the Vietnam Memorial, it's a long hike. So many vets choose to be in a wheelchair. And if they don't need to be a wheelchair, we let them push the guardians around. We don't, we're not fussy. But then we make a stop at the Marine Corps Memorial, go up to the New Air Force Memorial, and we go over to Arlington and witness the changing of the guard. And then we get back on the plane. We fly in and out of Orlando, so once we get to Orlando, then we get back on a bus and come back to the American Legion Post on 466 and Rolling Acres Road in Lady Lake, where we depart from and return to. And the thing we always try to do is to take and give the vets who are coming back home a rousing welcome that they never received when they finished their service during World War II. The realities of it are, at the end of World War II, it ended in August 45, but most of these vets didn't get home until sometime late 45 and early 46, and when they got back to this country, everyone was war-weary of anything that related to the war. They were tired of the news, they were tired of rationing, they were tired of all the news reports they got about the killings and the massacres and everything that was going on there, so they didn't want anything to do with the war. They just wanted to get back to work, so the vets never really got a welcome. In the last flight that we had that came back the end of April, we had 600 people that rolled out to see these vets at midnight and give them a great homecoming. And it really puts a lump in your throat and a tear in your eye when you see the reaction of these vets for it. They are just totally thankful for all the efforts that are put into it and all the thanks that they get from all the people. So our flights continue this year. We have about 175 vets that are on our waiting list. Currently, we are taking the most senior vets, which are the World War II vets. We do have some Korean War vets on them, but we will take and exhaust our list of World War II vets first. And if there's any terminally ill vet, they go right to the top of the list, and we'll fly them too. We don't have very many restrictions on the vets who can fly. You know, we want to know what their physical abilities are, but it's better so that we can better accommodate them during the flight. We're not really interested in saying they can't fly because of some condition they might have. We take a doctor with us on the flight. Each flight is broken down to five squads, and each squad of five vets and the five guardians has a medical person with them. So we try to make sure that the medical needs of all the vets are addressed, and we try to take every vet that we possibly can. And so far, any vet that wanted to go, we've been able to take them with us. We consider ourselves fortunate. What we're looking for is we continue to look for more vets. You know, we suspect that there's, the number we've heard is about 300 or 3,500 World War II vets that live in this area. A lot of them are difficult to find. You know, they're housebound, they're restricted, they don't have a lot of public access. So any opportunities that we have to go out and outreach to them, we want to do it. And that's one thing that everyone can help us with. If there's any organization or any group that would like to have us go up and make a presentation or go out to a small area and make a presentation to the vets, we would love to do it. And if anyone wants to get an application for a vet, they can go to our website. It's www.villageshonorflight.org. On that site, you can get an application to be for the veterans. You can get an application if you want to volunteer, and you get an application to be a guardian. One of the things we could use right now is we could use more guardians. The veterans always fly free, but the guardians have to pay their own way. And right now, the charge that we're putting to a guardian is $400. So that limits some of them, so the ability to do it. So we've got a somewhat of a need for guardians who could take and assist us on these flights. But the applications can be obtained on our website. We'd love to have people complete them and send them in. Vets right now are probably going to, World War II vets are probably going to be flying sometime next year. They won't be able to fly this year. But guardians, there's a good chance they could fly sometime towards the end of this year. We have sort of a unique situation coming up in our September flight. One of our past guardians is a member of one of the Marine Corps detachments in the area, and he has rounded up 25 other Marines. And we're going to have a flight where all of the guardians will be Marines. Not World War II Marines, but just Marines of different periods. So we know what the guardians will look like, but it's only guess what the Marines will look like when they show up. But we're looking forward to it, and we applaud them for stepping forward and doing it to help underwrite their cost. If anyone is available, the last Saturday in June, this Marine group is having a spaghetti dinner and a show up at the American Legion Post 347 up on Rolling Acres Road in 466. And the cost is $15. It's being put on by the American Legion for these veterans, and they're looking to raise money to cover their cost of these 25 vets going, or 25 guardians going to Washington. So I'll send you some more information on that, but we'd love to have people show up for that if they're available. They can accommodate 350 people for the dinner. And if there's tickets available, they can get them at the door, but in a past experience, they've been pretty well able to sell these out.
A question, John. If a wife wants to go as a guardian and push her husband around, is that possible?
It is not something we encourage.
Okay.
If she is able, it's possible to do that.
Yeah.
Our restrictions are that a guardian has to be under the age of 70. Mm-hmm. We'll take guardians up to the age of 70. Mm-hmm. If they are physically fit and their doctor says they are fit to fly, we'll take them up to age 75. Mm-hmm. So generally we discourage wives going. We really don't want to have that happen. There's a couple of reasons for it. Sometimes the wives, the relationship between the husband and wives, it becomes one where they want to bond with each other and they don't want to participate with the rest of the vets who are there, and they sort of get closed off from some of the other activities that are going on. Sometimes the wives are, I hate to say this, but they're totally controlling of the husbands, and so it's not a sightseeing trip. It's a trip for the guardians to go up, not a sightseeing trip for the guardians. I mean, it's a trip for them to attend to this veteran and be their valet for a day. Mm-hmm. And that relationship is sometimes difficult for the wives to understand.
And as their caregiver.
Right.
Mm-hmm. John, you talked about the fundraisers that they have, but how can somebody just donate to send a vet?
They can do that very easily. Right now, we're in the process of getting our own 501c3. But until we get that, we have the Veterans Memorial Post 347 is acting as our fiscal agent. And as you know, the 340, the American Legion posts are all tax exempt under 501c19. So anyways, they can make a donation to Veterans Memorial Post 347, Post Office Box 1534, Lady Lake, Florida 32158, and just indicate on the check that that it's an honor flight donation. And we're always accepting donations. Obviously, money comes in the door and money goes out the door. We don't bankroll anything. All of our staff is volunteer staff. We don't have any big overhead that we carry on with us. We don't have our own building. The American Legion has been very accommodating to us, letting use their facility for a bunch of things. The Villages has given us meeting space for a lot of our meetings, so that's where we stand.
All right. Curly, do you know the date for the last honor flight out of Ocala? It's the 23rd, right, of May?
That's the last I heard, John. Yeah. You know, because
and that'll be the last time. We just want to remind everybody to come out to the airport before 9, because that flight will be back, and just honor our heroes, and that'll be the last one going from Ocala. So
right.
We're
right.
Glad to see that you guys are picking up the ball and running with it, because we found that, you know, I was on that first flight, and it's just amazing, you know, to see those people go to the memorial. Some on our flight never were to Washington. You know, they served and they returned to their own little city, and that's where they spent all their time. So it's really great to see them. And the memorial was a long time in coming, but it's beautiful, and it's well worth the tour. And the tour of the other memorials and points of interest are great too.
Right.
And
in
a reception they usually get at the airports and at the memorial themselves are just outstanding. So
on our March flight, we flew into Reagan International, and when we got off the plane, we were walking down the jetway into the airport lobby, and there was a Medal of Honor winner there to welcome these vets. And the Medal of Honor winner, obviously he had some substantial damage from an IED, and he had lost his right arm and his right shoulder. He had a prosthesis, but he was there thanking the World War II vets for their service. I mean, it's an absolutely incredible experience and emotional experience for these vets. And the welcome that they get all over. I mean, John mentioned you get down into the memorial itself, and in there, there's some repairs going on there. So they've got the fountain shut down. They have some leakage into the electrical components, so they've got that shut down right now. But it doesn't detract from
reflecting pond.
Yeah, no, not the reflecting pond, but the memorial itself down in front. They got that big fountain that's there. That was leaking into the electrical component, so they had to shut it down while they repair that. But in our flight in May, there were 7 honor flights on the same day, and there must have been 2,000 people just roaming around the World War II Memorial. The place was packed, and it was difficult to get through when you're pushing a guardian, because pushing a vet. Because everybody wants to come up and shake the vet's hand. They want to give him a kiss. They want to thank him for what they've done. And it's amazing the outpouring of support and thanks goes to these individuals. And rightfully so, they deserve it.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
All right.
I've had the experience of touring Washington, D.C., but it was in the 1st of September.
Thank you.
I've had the experience of touring Washington, D.C., but it was in the 1st of September, so it wasn't too hot, it wasn't too cold. It was just was about right temperature, and they were just getting ready to unveil the Martin Luther King Memorial, even though it had been finished, but they weren't quite with the finishing touches on it yet, and they were just, putting up the railings and a lot of other stuff in there, too, so I got a chance to tour all of that and to see the all the monuments and everything like that, and tour with the buses, the open-top buses, and the one that we know went from downtown. So I had a very interesting experience up there during the month of September.
It is great.
One thing that we're looking for right now is, as I said before, each veteran on our trip gets a wheelchair. Mm-hmm. And we prefer to take them with us if we could, because it cuts down on some of our costs. So we got a need for good, serviceable wheelchairs, if anyone has anything they would like to donate. And a lot of times they're sitting around and people are trying to figure out, what do I do with it now? Well, we'd be interested in talking to them about donating it to the village's honor flight, because we have a need for about a dozen of them right now.
You got a phone number for that?
432-1382. 432-1382. Area code 352, of course.
Okay. Want to remind everybody again that Veterans News is brought to you by some people here in our community that make all this possible. Ford Lincoln of Ocala, their goal is to ensure that they're one of the best Ford Lincoln dealers in all of Florida, and I'm sure they'd like to be number one in the nation as well. They offer a great selection of new and used cars and trucks. They have financing, lease specials, and other specials on their vehicles. That's all backed up by parts and repair and service for your Lincoln and Ford especially, but they do other products as well. And they also have a outlet down at called Village Ford in Bellevue, and we're looking forward to that new dealership or the new building opening up for your needs. And we have our newest sponsor is St. Leo University of Ocala. They provide educational training, especially for vets, and it's approved under the GI Bill. They participate as a member of the Yellow Ribbon Program. Because they're located here in Ocala, that's flexible and convenient for you, and they're going to guarantee that you get personal attention from the start until graduation, and they provide affordable academic excellence.
So, John, how about letting the folks know about what is the Yellow Ribbon Program? Because a lot of them probably don't know.
Why don't you
that.
Tell us?
I don't know that much about it myself other than...
See, he was going to throw me under the bus.
Yeah, this is...
I'm not sure if it's the yellow ribbons on the trees or...
Or the yellow ribbons... pins that they were passing out at one time. I know it.
That's a good question. Do you know that?
Make it a trivia question.
No,
he only wrote this for us, right? For us dummies to read. I don't want to say something that's wrong because I'm not positive. We'll look that up and we'll mention that at, when we do the commercials next time, right?
Maybe we can ask them to call and explain what is the Yellow Ribbon Program.
Right.
Yeah. And our sponsor forever almost, so right from the beginning, has been Robert's Funeral Homes and Cemeteries. Their caring, knowledgeable staff provides 24-hour assistance. They're a full-service, reputable facility. You always get an itemized list of the costs involved, and they'll accommodate your needs and requests during your time of bereavement. And they've been doing all that good stuff for over 120 years in our community. And I see Larry looks like he's Googling Yellow Ribbon Program. Also, I want to remind everybody, Don Harrison went out with Hank. I don't know, there's two of them together. Yeah, he went out with Hank. Yeah, we'll start that rumor, right?
Yeah.
But Don is the director of another upcoming event. It's the first annual fundraiser for Vets Helping Vets. And it's going to be held out at Golden Ocala, and it's October 18th and 19th, and a bunch of us are going around soliciting funds, and it's going to come to Marion County Veterans Helping Vets, that's us, and their motto is American heroes shouldn't be homeless, so they're going to help us try to help those vets that are in dire needs sometimes. And that's a joint project of the Free and Accepted Masons of the 15th District of Florida, the Marine Corps League 61, and Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. So that's coming up in the future, and Donna will be here next week talking about that and remind everybody, too, if they'd like to make donations to Vets Helping Vets, they can do it. Either can they can mail in contributions to our office, which is on 1527 Northeast 8th Avenue here in Ocala, and that's 434-470. Or you can just call up and find out more information at 433-2320. And besides donations, we also have a great need for food. There was a lot of articles in the paper. This week, the postal people are collecting. I think they collect on Saturday for the food banks and to help people. And we probably go through about 1,000 pounds of non-perishable items every week. So we're always in need, too. So I remind everybody to do that.
Would you like the yellow ribbon?
Yeah, tell us about the yellow ribbon.
All right. The question is, what is the yellow ribbon program? And the answer from their website is, the yellow ribbon program is a provision of the law that created the post-911 GI Bill. The program is available for institutions of higher learning, which are institutions that offer degrees, in the United States or at a branch of such institution located outside the U.S. The program allows approved institutions of higher learning and the VA to partially or fully fund tuition and fee expenses that exceed the established thresholds under the post-911 GI Bill.
All right, so
they help pay for it.
It wasn't what we basically thought, went back maybe to the yellow ribbons on the trees. It's actually tied to they're actually a participant in the with the VA funding to provide that tuition assistance or whatever, and accept those into those programs through the GI Bill.
And one more thing, if for those eligible, it says here to find out if you're eligible, if you are eligible for the post-911 GI Bill, you're not automatically eligible for the Yellow Ribbon Program. It says only veterans or dependents under the transfer of entitlement at the 100% benefit level qualify.
All right.
Active duty members and spouses, therefore, are not eligible for the program. In addition, the institution must be approved to participate in the program, the school, in other words.
Yeah, well, thank you, Larry, for enlightening us, right? Yeah. That's a Google thing, right?
Yeah, it's a Google thing.
All right. Curly, did you want to remind us again of what's going on?
Oh, yeah. Just one more time, and we'll not remind everybody that the VFW Post 7193 is having its monthly meeting. It is today at 6 p.m. at the Mount Moriah Missionary Baptist Church Annex. This is located at 55 Southwest 3rd Avenue, right downtown Ocala. Also, the Ladies Auxiliary of the VFW Post 7193 will have its meeting at 4:30 at the same place. Also, the District 22 will have its meeting on Saturday, starting at 11 o'clock, at the Astor Post, which is located in Astor, Florida. The number is either 9886 or 9868, which is on Highway 40 East, headed on out like you're going to Daytona Beach, Florida. Also, like to remind everybody, the Ray Missionary Baptist Church out in Bellevue or Ocala, on what they call Old Baseline Road, is having a Mother's Day celebration for the ladies of the Mother's Day celebration. It's going to be starting at 3 p.m. for the mothers of Ray Missionary Baptist Church. All men will be there to help serve the ladies. So be there or be square. We thank you much for all that you do, and especially WOCA 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
Wow.
All right.
Could I add something about the honor flight? There's a film I wanted to do. I don't know if you knew about it. There's a film that is being shown at the Appleton Museum on May 26th at 2 p.m. It's titled Honor Flight, One Last Mission, and I don't know if that's free or not. Is Robin up there? I don't know. But anyway, it's at the Appleton.
At the Appleton, yep.
I have seen that film.
I saw that film.
It's an incredible film.
Have you? Okay.
And I've got copies of it. So if anyone needs a copy, we have them available for sale for $20 for the home version. So, but if you get an opportunity, go up to Appleton to see it. It's an absolutely incredible movie. It's about a town in Wisconsin that gets together. They decide they're going to take and spend their family.
Oh, wow.
Or spend the vets from their community. Yeah, on a disc. Yeah. Yes. And that's how they all rally together. And for some of these vets, unfortunately, it turned out to be their last flight also.
But, yeah.
You can't expect that with the age that we're looking at, but it's a real heart-rendering movie to watch.
Joe was telling me, and I might have the number wrong, but the flight that is going this later this month is the make-good flight from the last one,
from
right?
Last
because
one,
it
yeah.
had mechanical problems.
Yep.
That 14 of the men who were on that flight
have passed away.
Yep. Wow. Yeah. That's just...
It's unbelievable.
You just realize how quickly they're going, you know?
Yeah. Our mission is to get all the vets there, but time is not on our side, so we're moving as quickly as we can. So if there's any vets out there, we need to find them. We need to get them an application from them. We need to get them to Washington quickly.
Yeah.
And what's that number to call for donations or whatever, if you want to do that?
Well, if they want to make a donation, they send it to the American Legion Post 347, P.O. Box 1534, Lady Lake, Florida, 32158.
All right.
You just indicated it's for honor flight.
And we thank everybody for listening, and we wish everybody well, and may God bless America.
The night with the light from above, from the mountain to the prairie, to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Ocala's Information Station, 1370 WOCA.
Ocala!
ABC News Now. I'm Karen Chase. Beaten, bound, restrained, and assaulted. That's how a Cleveland prosecutor described the ordeal of three women at the arraignment of Ariel Castro, who's charged with kidnapping and rape. Bond was set at $8 million. Castro kept his head down during the entire hearing and did not enter a plea. Investigators in Michigan say a small amount of blood from a missing gas station clerk was found at the scene where she disappeared almost a week ago. She vanished just as she was closing up shop. Jody Ariel...